Wilhelm Schickard's name is sometimes written as Schickard or Schickard or Schickert. His mother was Marguerite Gamelin, the daughter of a Lutheran pastor, and his father was Lucas Schickard. The Schickard family was originally from the county of Nassau but had moved south in the middle of the 15th century. Lucas Schickard's father, who was a sculptor, had settled in Herrenberg about 30 kilometers south of Stuttgart. Lucas Schickard trained to be a carpenter, as did his brother Heinrich Schickard, who was Wilhelm's uncle. Heinrich Schickard became an architect and went on to become the main architect of the Renaissance in southwestern Germany. Wilhelm was brought up in Herrenberg but, at an early age, won a scholarship to attend the monastery school in Bebenhausen, just north of Tübingen. After attending the monastery school in Bebenhausen, he entered the University of Tübingen. He received his first degree of B.A. in 1609, followed by an M.A. in 1611, both in theology and Oriental languages, and he continued to study these topics at Tübingen until 1613. While studying at Tübingen, he was taught mathematics and astronomy by Michael Maslin. In 1613, Schickard became a Lutheran minister and was assigned to churches in towns around Tübingen. In 1614, he was appointed deacon in Nürtingen. He continued this work with the Lutheran Church until 1619. It was during his time as a Lutheran minister that he first met Johannes Kepler, who came to Tübingen to support his mother, who had been charged with witchcraft. Kepler was working on his Harmony of the World at this time and, after meeting Schickard, he was so impressed with his abilities that he asked him to do some engravings and woodcuts for the book and also asked him to assist in calculating some tables. This is not as surprising as it might first sound since, among his other skills, Schickard was renowned as an engraver both in wood and in copperplate. The authors of Wright. It was his work with Kepler which prompted him to think about making a machine to mechanize the astronomical calculations he was doing. This was to come a little later, however, so first we will describe the next phase of Schickard's life as a professor of Hebrew. In 1619, he left his work in the Lutheran Church when he was appointed as the professor of Hebrew at the University of Tübingen. Schickard was a universal scientist and taught biblical languages such as Aramaic as well as Hebrew. His efforts to improve the teaching of his subject show remarkable innovation. He strongly believed that, as the professor, it was part of his job to make it easier for his students to learn Hebrew. One of his inventions to assist his students was the Hebrea Rota. This mechanical device displayed conjugation of Hebrew verbs by having two rotating discs laid on top of each other, the respective forms of conjugation appearing in the window. He also created the Horologium Hebraeum, a textbook of Hebrew divided into 24 chapters, each chapter containing material which could be learnt in an hour. He wrote another textbook, the Hebraischen Trichter, for German students of Hebrew, in 1627. However, his research was broad and, in addition to Hebrew, included astronomy, mathematics and surveying. In astronomy he invented a conic projection for star maps in the astroscopium. His star maps of 1623 consist of cones cut along the meridian of a solstice with the pole at the center and apex of the cone. He also made significant advances in map-making, showing how to produce maps which were far more accurate than those which were currently available. His most famous work on cartography was Kurs Anweisung, Wie Künstliche Landtafeln aus Rechtem Grund zu Machen, 1629. Long before Pascal and Leibniz, Schickard invented a calculating machine, the Rechner, in 1623. He wrote to Kepler on the 20th of September 1623. Kepler clearly showed an interest in having one of Schickard's calculators since Schickard gave instructions for one to be built for him. However, the half-built computer was destroyed by fire, as he explained in another letter to Kepler written on the 25th of February 1624. In this letter, he gives some more details of the way the machine is constructed. In 1631, Schickard had rather a change of subject, being appointed to the chair of mathematics and astronomy at the University of Tübingen, left vacant by the death of his teacher Michael Maslin. This change did not signify a major shift in his interests, however, for as we indicated above, he had always had broad interests across a wide range of subjects. For example, he lectured on architecture, fortification, and hydraulics. He also undertook land surveying of the Duchy of Württemberg, which involved the first use of Willibrord Snell's triangulation method in geodesic measurements, see 6, for further details. As professor of astronomy, Schickard lectured on the topic and undertook research into the motion of the moon. He published Ephemeris Lunaris in 1631, which allowed the position of the moon to be determined at any time. We should note that, at a time when the Church was trying to insist that the Earth was at the center of the universe, Schickard was a staunch supporter of heliocentric system. We have mentioned above Schickard's correspondence with Kepler, but he corresponded with many other astronomers, including Ismael Bouliau and Pierre Gassendi. The Thirty Years' War, 1618-1648, affected much of the later part of Schickard's life. Following the Battle of Nordlingen in September 1634, when the Catholic army, augmented by many Spanish troops, won a decisive victory over the Protestant army, the victorious troops occupied Tübingen. The troops brought with them the bubonic plague, and the population of Tübingen was badly affected. Over the next year, Schickard's wife and all his children died from the plague. He was the last of the family to succumb to the bubonic plague, dying either on the day given above or, possibly, one day earlier. Although Schickard's contributions were not fully recognized during his lifetime, he is remembered today with the Wilhelm Schickard Institute für Informatik at the University of Tübingen and the Wilhelm Schickard Schule in Tübingen.